together. But if any group need to make party and they do everything haram, they can do it generally. But if you need to pray at night before Fajr, the name is Tahajjud, we have to do it very secret. And it means for me, we are minority in Egypt before revelation, even we are the majority for the number. Actually, when I introduce this church, to be honest with you, in the front of Sheikh Al-Qaradawi, Sheikh Al-Qaradawi, Sheikh Hussein Hamid Hassan, biggest scholar in the world, and we are member, alhamdulillah, I am a member of Fiqh Council in Europe, Fiqh Council in America, Fiqh Council in India, and another Fiqh Council in our Islamic countries, but I told them we have to consider any Islamic country, if the Muslim there not have their human rights to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to practice their or our Quran and the Sunnah, we live as a minority. But as I mentioned, to be honest, they agree with me for the first aspect and thus agree with me about the second aspect. And still, my opinion is the minorities, it means few number the front of the majority or little bit of rights. You don't have enough rights. In Nigeria, the Muslim 125 million Muslim, and the Muslim have no rights and the disbelievers have all the rights. What does it mean? They live less than the minorities. Actually, the worst issue is when I live in Egypt or in Saudi Arabia or in Sultanate Oman or in Bahrain, I have rights less than if I live in the USA, if I live in Japan, if I live in Europe. This is really a problem. Because we have to think about the objective. المقاصد في النهاية أنا مرتاح إن أنا أعبد ربي وفق شريعة الله ولا أنا مش قادر. يعني I can worship my Lord as Allah commanded me in His book, the Holy Book, and to follow the direction of our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم or not. I am still believe in the minority, not only the matter of number. It is a matter of number and rights. This is the definition of minority. When I think about the minority, we try to make the ضوابط منهجية لفقه الأقليات, the frame to make اجتهاد, to think about how to make Muslim in the as a minority live with his religion with the best way. The Muslim minorities, maybe they are original citizen people from like Indian Muslim, like Somalian Muslim, like brothers and sisters in China, 175 million Muslim, in Turkmenistan, all the people Muslim there. So they are citizen, or some Muslim immigrated like you come to the Japan. Million of Muslim migrated to the USA, the Europe, migrate, for they are not originally there. They are looking for knowledge, looking for freedom, looking for money, or looking for good health insurance. يعني good treatment. This is the most reason the Muslim come from the majority Islamic countries to live as a minority. When I think about this the fiqh of minorities, many scholars, they told us, you are make something against the Sharia, because the Sharia has no difference between majorities and minorities. We said it is true with something, not true or untrue with another things. For example, we cannot change the prayer of Jum'ah. It has to be in the day of Jum'ah. We cannot make it on Sunday. I received a question from the jinn in Boston. Some Muslims in the jail, and they told me, can we pray Salatul Jum'ah in the day of Sunday? Because the only day we have some time as a vacation or holiday day, we have time to pray Salatul Jum'ah. I told them it's okay. We cannot change Salatul Jum'ah to be Salatul Ahad. The surah in the Quran, it is Salatul Jum'ah. We cannot say, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْأَحَدِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعَ. We will believe if the Muslim said, حَيَّ عَلَى الصَّلَاةِ الدَّيْلِ وَفَأَحَدْ. No, it is the day of Jum'ah. We cannot change it. And we have many masajid in our Islamic country as a majority. Like four fiqh of minority, we only have some ijtihad according to the circumstances in the West as a minority. For example, for Salat al-Jum'ah, we received many questions from the Muslim community. We don't have mosque, I don't have money, we don't have earth to build a mosque between the among the Muslim community. Can we pray Salat al-Jum'ah twice in the same mosque? It is not. You cannot find it in any Islamic country. Salat al-Jum'ah or Tid together. But in the faith of minority, we agree to pray many times of Jum'ah. But I pray many times. يعني I meet khutbah here and another khutbah in the same day. Some brothers, when I go to the mosque, go to any state in the USA, they said it's a good chance for us. Please, if you make khutbah for the first khutbah, our brother and sister in the second khutbah will argue why you don't give us Dr. Sultan to make khutbah. I mean three khutbahs in the same day. بس بخلي واحد يصلي إمام، بصلي مرة واحدة وواحد بيصلي الباقي. ف we can pray three times in the mosque of Adam in Virginia, very close to beside Washington DC. They pray five times. Jum'ah five times in the same mosque. Because we have no land to buy, we have no money to buy, we have no way. And the Muslim community increased. The number go up. We agreed to pray five times in the same month. Because it's the situation. And the other ijtihad is, you know what does it mean ijtihad? Ijtihad. Ijtihad to think about Sharia and they make a decision according to Sharia. This is the main, yani scholars think about the decision of Sharia according to the Quran and Sunnah. We made ijtihad about the time of Jum'ah. We found Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, the mother of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, said the time of Salat al-Jum'ah can start after sunrise 1 hour. You can start to pray Salat al-Jum'ah if sunrise come here at 6 o'clock. You can start to pray Salat al-Jum'ah from 7. 1 hour, 1 hour and a half after sunrise. And Imam Malik said you can pray Salat al-Jum'ah until before Maghrib. Yani from فقرة إعلانية بس كذا. فالإمام مالك يجيز صلاة الجمعة حتى ما قبل المغرب. يعني در مالكي مذهب agree to pray صلاة المغرب until صلاة الجمعة until before sunrise. Then you have long time. You can pray Salat start, because if you pray 5 times, you have to start before the regular time of Salat al-Jum'ah, Salat al-Zuhr. Yani at 12, Salat al-Zuhr at 12, you can start at 10 to pray the first Salat, and the second Salat at 11:30, the third Salat at 1 o'clock, the fourth Salat at 2:50, and the last Salah you can do it at 4 or 5. This is because we have no way. The replace is, again, people will not pray Salat al-Jum'ah. And we think about the madhahib, and we take from many madhahib to make it easy for people. So, when you think about fiqh of minority, we cannot leave any principles in Islam. We cannot. But we come to that something, not the principle, and think about what the ijtihad of ulama and try to find out a solution. Another example. In our Islamic law, in the majority Muslim in our Islamic country, if someone changed his religion, he became non-Muslim, he cannot inherit from his father, from his family. But we received a question from one Muslim in Italia, in Britannia, in London, UK. He said, I convert to Islam. We are two persons, two kids, two sons. And my father, very rich. I used to live in very lecture life. Now I convert to Islam. My father died. If I don't take my right, all the money will go to my brother, and my brother drink alcohol and drugs every day and night. It is acceptable in Islam to give him the chance to take all of this money. And because I converted to Islam, I have to live as a very poor man and make a conference for the scholars and make search. 40 scholars can search about that. The end, who found the Imam Zayd ibn Thabit. Zayd ibn Thabit, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, akhbarana wa afraduha Zayd, the best scholar about the inheritance is Zayd radiallahu anhu. He said, non-Muslim can inherit the Muslim. And Muslim, sorry, Muslim can inherit non-Muslim. And you found Imam, his big Imam, Imam Abu Hanifa, he said it is acceptable in Islam, Muslim can inherit non-Muslim. What about the hadith? لا يرث المسلم الكافر. Imam said when we have war between Muslim and non-Muslim, they are relatives. That this is the only case if we have a war. يعني في حرب بين مسلم وغير مسلم لا يرث هذا من ذاك. لا يرث المسلم الكافر الحربي المحارب. And we made the fatwa for the new Muslim because we found a lot of new Muslim. They cannot have any money after Islam. And we, as you know, we are a Muslim يعني minorities. We have no money just to pay the bill of elected of our Islamic sectors. If anyone convert to Islam and these leave every money from father, mother, and sister, and they come to live as a needy or orphan, no. It will make people think 100 times before to convert to Islam. And this is the only thing can prevent a lot of people to come to Islam, to convert to Islam. We cannot accept very little thing in Islam to prevent people to become Muslim. And we made search and discussion 5 days between the scholars. And we made the fatwa after that. This is, we don't read as you see, we don't read the principles, and at the same time, we can go for the difference opinion between ulama and look for their reference. It is good or not? It is acceptable or not? It is related with the occult, the objective of Sharia, maqasid al-Sharia or not? Then we start to find out solution from those people. Another example. During the time of the war from America against Afghanistan, it started 2001, after 9/11. We found many of youth came from Afghanistan to live in the USA under the we take care about those people, those kids, because their father killed and they need to take care about them. The real issue is to raise some of Afghanistan's kids on the regime of America. And they will be the people of America, not the people of Afghanistan. And after 10 years, they will send them again to control everything in Afghanistan. They brought them to the USA, and we went to receive them. They refused. We have a system. If you take him as a son of you, we'll give him to you. And it happened. If you take him as an orphan or something, we refuse. Now, we have a big problem in the future. Those people will not be Muslim. They bring him to eat the pork in the refrigerator, alcohol, no water, alcohol, everything bad. And dancing at night, every night, and you see your kids will be converted to Christian or Jewish or any or non-religion. And our citizens in Afghanistan, they will be very dangerous for the future of Afghanistan. Then we said, you can take this, every family can take one, and dream it as a son, but we have to write in the Islamic Center, he is not the real son. Will not inherit. He will not get that, and this, and this. And ask those people to write his wealth as according to the Sharia, will not inherit as a real son. We make some of precaution, yes. Yani some of this ways to make the less of harm. Alhamdulillah, we save many and many Muslim to be non-Muslim, to be fasiq, to be against the Muslim in the future, to prevent the U.S. government to control Afghanistan and the world through those kids. This is a way to understand when we think about the fiqh of minorities. We didn't leave any principle, but we consider it, but we work to achieve the objective of Sharia. I made 10 principles. When we think about ijtihad, in the fiqh of minorities. And I deliver all of those in the front of the scholars and they agree, alhamdulillah, before I made it a book. Al-Ijtihad, Dawabit al-Manhajiyya fi al-Ijtihad fi fiqh al-Aqaliyyat al-Muslim. The first one is stressing citizenship legality. If you get citizenship in Japan, act as a Japani. You have to love this land. You have to work this country good and strong. Because they give you the chance to worship Allah with your abilities. They prevent you to pray, to build a mosque, to make conference, to do many things. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam immigrated from Mecca to Medina. The first thing he made dua to Mecca, oh Allah, I ask you to bless Yathrib as you bless Mecca, or Yazid, or more. As Allah, you accept the prayer from Ibrahim to Mecca. Sayyidina Ibrahim made dua for Mecca, for safety, for fruits, for many good things. And Sayyidina Rasul made the same thing for the new citizen. And some of diseases, al-humma in Medina, Rasul made dua, waqi al-humma ila Jaffa, to be clean area. And it became Tiba. Tiba, it means Tayyibat al-hawa wal-ma wal-ghida wal-akhlaq. Clear for food, good for food, for water, for air, for manners. This is the meaning of Tiba. And this is a lesson for us. If you live in any country, try to be the good man for this country, to love this country. It is not acceptable in Islam to take information, knowledge from this country, health insurance from this country, freedom from this country, and the end, you Christ this country and say this is bad, very bad country, and you work against this country. No, it isn't acceptable in Islam. Leave this country if you need to do anything like this. Leave it. Uh, in Switzerland, I asked many students. They have come and invited me. Where are you from? They said, from Pakistan. Another one, where are you from? I am from Jordan. Third one, where are you from? I am from Egypt. Where are you from? From Morocco. I came back to them again. Did you get breath in Yali? In Morocco or Pakistan or Jordan or Egypt? No, I raised here, I was born here, I learned here. My father from Pakistan, my father from India, my father from Morocco. I said, it is not shame to say, I am Swiss man, or Germany, or France, or American, or Japanese. My family originally from Pakistan, from any country. The most of our companions used to live to other countries. And they were very, very good for everyone in this country. There's no problem to say I am Muslim Farsi, originally from Pakistan, originally from Malaysia, originally from Sri Lanka, originally from Egypt. No problem for that. Why some people, you know, when I went to the USA, someone told me I need to talk with you, and they said, I am engineering, build for the building. You will start the paper to have green card in the USA and the passport after that, citizenship. I said, yes. He said, it is haram. I told him, I am imam here. I am a sheikh here. I have PhD in the fiqh. But you have bachelor in engineering. If I start to build houses, it will destroy the front and above the people. Also, if you make a fatwa, you'll destroy everything. You cannot make fatwa, I cannot make a building. Do something you know very well. How many years you have been here? He said 27 years. You didn't make any paper, don't have any paper about citizenship, about Greek cards, said no. Why? It is haram. How you live here? Why you stay here in this country? Did you see your family in your country? Your father, your mother? 27 years he can't go out and because he cannot come in. And he married American woman. She converted to Islam. But he cannot go to visit, and his kids didn't see her, their grandfather or grandmother. I told them, أطعت رحمة وتعيش مهددا هذه معيشة لا. This is all of this against Islam. قال لي أنا بقول لك إنها حرام. قلت له شوف أنت عامل زي اللي قالوا ديك رومي كانوا كله قاعد يمصمص في العظم بتاعه وقالوا له أنت لسه بتمصمص في العظم ليه؟ ما قدامك شوربة الديك الرومي. قال لا الشوربة كانت ديك الرومي حرام. قلت له أنت مصمصت أمريكا بقالك 27 سنة وجاي تقول تخديم على الاوراق حرام؟ مش ممكن يعني. ف some people think out of the principles of Sharia. ف it is okay to have this citizenship and feel you are one of the people in this country. There is no harm for the native citizen to be proud of his country if it is, doesn't translate to action by the government or it is law that are not accordance with his or his religion. البعض يقول دي دولة كافرة وإحنا دولة مسلمة. How to leave دولة مسلمة to live in دولة كافرة, the Islamic country to, إحنا ما عندناش مصطلح هذه دولة كافرة, هذا system not Islamic system. And Islam commands us to go everywhere in the world to spread your message, not to live in your own street and not to go out. وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة العالمين. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يقول خلوا بيني وبين الناس. I need to be among people. Let me to talk with any human being in the world. Number two, emphasizing the responsibility for reforming one's country. I would like to remind all of you about Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam used to work with many kind of disbelievers. The people who worship idols, worship the moon and the stars and the sun, the people who worship the leader, Namrud. The people of Lot, they were gays. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him very, very good news for Sayyidina Ibrahim. Allah will provide him Ishaq wa min wara'i Ishaq Ya'qub. It is two kind of good news. Kids and long life to see your grandson. But he was busy about his people, the people of Lot. وَجَاءَتْهُ الْبُشْرَى يُجَادِلُنَا فِي قَوْمِ لُوط. Oh Allah, don't destroy the people of Lot. Leave us to do again and again and again, to remind them again and again and again. Oh my God. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, very concerned about the people of Lot, busy about the new, very important good news for his and his family, because he wanted to continue to advise them, to invite them to be clean people from this very bad sin. And they asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, leave us more time, we need more time to advise them. This is the way, my brothers and sisters, we have to feel about any non-Muslim, any bad Muslim, our responsibility to invite them to come to them and ask them, please come to us. We're concerned about you. We need to have good life in this life and the hereafter. So if you live anywhere, you have to be very care about people around you. This is some of aspects we can work together with non-Muslim. A lot of aspects, a lot of things, good things, we can share with them. We can participate with them, with anything good for the world, for women, for kids, for manners, against drugs, against diseases, against a lot of things. Caring for the poor, the victims of war and the refugees all over the world, fighting drugs and smoking. We can work. We have big area to work together. Number we have to understand the reality. You know what happens everywhere in the world? When you invite in a scholar, first time go out of his country. The first time he come, the people ask him about everything in their life. He has knowledge about Sharia, but he has nothing about the reality. And the Imam Shatibi قال الفقه ثلاثة أنواع فقه النص وفقه الواقع وفقه إنزال النص على الواقع. To understand the Sharia, number one. To understand the reality, الواقع. And then to understand how to make relation between this and this. إنزال النص على الواقع. وقال الشاطبي وفقه النص والواقع مكتسبان أما فقه إنزال النص على الواقع فتلك موهبة يعطيها الله من يشاء من عباده. You can make your offer to understand the Quran and the Sunnah, to understand the reality, but it is just a blessing from Allah to help you to make this connection between Sharia and the reality. It is just a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It needs iman, needs asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to try to fix the reality by the Sharia. When I went to the USA, people ask from the day one. First time I went to the USA about the mortgage. What is the mortgage? The mortgage. To go to the bank and have loan and please, give me 1 year. I will not make any fatwa here until to understand the reality. No, 1 year is a long time. 1 year. I will not give any fatwa until it's taken 1 year. And I went every state and asked people about everything and studied the university and do this and read. Then start to make the first fatwa after 1 year. We need to listen. And unfortunately, some people, when any new sheikh come to our community, take him alone. I need this fatwa from you. If the sheikh fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will tell him, please give me chance to understand the whole picture. The whole picture. Because sometimes part of the picture, it gives bad image, bad decision. You have to understand the whole picture. الاجتهاد في أصله يجب أن يكون to me and said I forget to pray inside the brain to recite small surah after Fatiha. I can make a fatwa of this. It's okay. Anyone can make a fatwa of this. Yani, he finished his bachelor degree in Sharia. But if someone came to me and he told me, please, we have thousands of sisters convert to Islam, it is right to stay with her husband non-Muslim? Oh, if we say no, many of those will lose their life, the kids will lose their father, many of sisters will lose the covering of material life, money. We will prevent a lot of sisters to convert to Islam. Oh, leave us. We stay 2 years with that. We went with this problem to the Islamic Fiqh Council and start to make search and discussion 2 years until we get the decision about this issue. You cannot say by yourself. You need to more understanding, more discussion. عندنا في الفقه الاستمرار في قضية خاصة قضية عامة بها البلوى. عمل بها البلوى يعني قضية عامة. قضية مهمة. The big issues. We ask شيخ الخرضاوي for the big issues in our Muslim فقه minority. Don't make fatwa alone. And شيخ الخرضاوي now, even he's the best and the biggest scholar in the world, والله if you receive any fatwa about something big, something important for the community, for the Muslim minority, he said, we can search about it, we can discuss it in the body meeting of the Fiqh Council in Europe. And we start research on this. This is a way to have good decision. We stayed at least 3 years to study together, to have discussion about the mortgage. 3 years. And search a lot, many books, many search, many. And we brought the people from the bank, not Islamic bank, non-Muslim bank. What is the methods? What is the good? What is the bad? What is the conditions? All the conditions. And the end, we have decision about this issue. If you have a small thing, anyone can make fatwa. But big thing has to make with the Fiqh Council. And I encourage, 3 years ago I came here, and 2 years also came here, I encourage every time to start to make the Fiqh Council in Japan. The Fiqh Council in Japan. And we can do it for you. بإذن الله تعالى. To understand the reality with understanding the Sharia and make a decision for the public problems, not small problems. Sometimes we need some decision to come to visit us in the Fiqh Council because the topic is related with decisions. With the, yani something is not yani 100% of Sharia. Something we need some people come from the accounting. Sometimes we ask people to come from the political aspect. Please tell us about the political side. When we have fatwa about critical issues, like integration. Integration, we made 2 conferences about what is the best way to make integration between Muslim and non-Muslim. 2 conferences. And alhamdulillah, we get very good vision and mission, and to encourage Muslim with this principle. This aspect is very important to my brothers and sisters. لا بد في الفتوى أن تبحث عن صاحب الحب الشرعية والخشية القلبية. Look for the imam who fear Allah and have very good knowledge about Sharia. العالم الذي لا يعرف شريعة بشكل عميق يلبس على الناس دينهم. والذي يعرف الشريعة ولا يخاف الله يدلس على الناس في دينهم. والأمة تضيع بين التدليس والتلبيس. If the scholar has good knowledge and he doesn't fear Allah, he can change the decision of Sharia according to how much you will give me, how much you will bless me, how much how يعني can I stay in my position as an imam, as a mufti or something like this. We have to look for both. Both. الذين يبلغون رسالات الله ويخشونه ولا يخشون أحدا إلا الله. The people who deliver the message and they fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى. فلا تخشوهم واخشوني. وهناك نوعان من العلماء، من يسوغ للحكام ومن يسوغ للعوام. سوغ العوام عشان يظل إمام في الحتة اللي هو فيها. سوغ للحكام عشان ياخذ منصب ويبقى وزير ولا مدير ولا وفير ولا اي شيء. والاجتهاد يجب ان يكون اجتهادا اصلاحيا وليس اجتهادا تسويقيا. Some scholar don't look for Allah, the blessing from Allah. وإنما look for the basic for people. People, general people or the authority people. And the scholar, real scholar have to fear Allah and only please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you meet any fatwa. عندما تنظر if you look for any imam, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad, Imam Malik, all of them, they are very rich for knowledge, also very rich in their soul, in their spirituality. They fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Imam Abu Hanifa al-Nu'man, he refused to be a judge. لما أرسل له هارون الرشيد وقال لماذا ترفض أن تكون قاضيا لي؟ أنت إذا تعترض على نظام الحكم عندي. قال إنني غير مأمون في الرضا فكيف أكون مأمونا في الغضب وأنا سريع الغضب. قال كذبت، أنت مأمون في الرضا والغضب. قال حكمت على نفسك يا أمير المؤمنين، وهل يصلح أن تولي قاضيا كذابا؟ مش تقول أنت كذبت يبقى أنا ما أصلحش أكون قاضي. الإمام أبو حنيفة refused to be a judge for the خليفة هارون الرشيد because he feared الله سبحانه وتعالى. But his student أبو يوسف accept but he was very fear when he the last time before death used to cry. Imam Abu Yusuf cry. They told him you were the very fear just yani a judge, why you cry like this? قال والله لقد حكمت بالعدل في كل القضايا إلا قضية واحدة كان الحق لأمير المؤمنين على نصراني فخشيت أن يقول عوام الناس أنه حكم لأمير المؤمنين ليلقيه في مكانه فحكمت للنصراني على أمير المؤمنين. إمام أبو حنيفة إمام أبو يوسف said when he cried before death he told us that والله all my decision is according to Sharia. They fear Allah. It is a part of justice. Except one case. It was between the Khalifa, the leader of our Ummah, and Christian man. And the right with the Khalifa. And I am afraid the most people will say he made the decision with the Khalifa because he wants to bless the Khalifa and يعني make him staying in his position. And I made the rights to the Christian man, not for the real issue to be the with the Khalifa. And I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please tell him to forgive him for me. You know, عندما يخرج عن الحق يخرج لصالح النصراني. طيب we'll go very fast. Applying the objectives of فقه. This is very, very important issue. Don't look only for the... Assalamu alaikum, brother. Ila salam. How are you doing? Nice to see you. Don't look only for the decision of Sharia, the objectives of Sharia. We have many things about that. Maybe when you have question, I will start with this sometime. عايز امشي بسرعه نوقف عشان خاطر الاسئله. لا عشان بس وعدينا للناس انا ما تبقاش الوقت عدى. نعم الله يرضى عليك. I think very important to consider all the madahib, the different madahib. We consider in the fiqh of minority all the madahib. Don't come here in the USA or Japan or in Europe and say I will consider only the Hanafi or Shafi or Maliki or Hanbali madhab. We have to consider all the madahib. As we mentioned, we don't have enough space to pray Salat al-Jum'ah together one time. We need to pray it at many places, 3 times. And we have to start before Dhuhr. It's acceptable in Madhab Imam Abi Hanifa, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. But we will continue until Salat al-Asr. We will start to pray Salat al-Jum'ah after Salat al-Asr. It is acceptable for the, according to the Madhab of Imam Malik. We take all of this. When we have the fatwa about starting Ramadan and the ending of Ramadan, it is big issue. Some people only, we have to follow the direction of Saudi Arabia. Please, we follow the direction of Sharia from all the madhab, the best madhab for us here. We can meet our calendar for 10 years. After now, 10 years. We pray 5 times every day. We go to look for the moon or look for the sun. We pray 5 times every day according to the Hisab al-Falak al-Hawai. Now? Yes. Yeah, it's through calculation. And we don't need all the time to look for the moon or for the sun or... No. Why we make it very hard every year? And non-Muslim in the schools, and the student, I need to take vacation at Saturday, and you at Sunday, and at Monday. Why? Your celebration is different. Because this mother Hanif, mother Malki, mother Shafi, mother. It is unacceptable. We live together. And you have to consider one mother, one way. And agree, all of us, and we come together. This is very important for all of us. We pray Salat al-Asr. Salat al-Asr, mother Shafi, before mother Malki, 1 hour. Mother Hanafi. If we need to gather all the documents, we can make Salat al-Asr after 1 hour in the first time. And because some Hanafis people said, this is not the time for our prayer. Yes, and move to big issues. We learn people to respect all the madhahib. We cannot follow in the fiqh of minority one madhab. You know, Shafi, Hanafi, Maliki, Abu Hanifa, all of this scholar, they made a fatwa, all of them. If someone said to his wife, "Antitalik Salatan with one more, I divorce you 3 times with one more," all of them, he cannot bring him a girl as a wife. It is three times. And Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, Imam Ahmad Ibn Al-Qayyim, he went against the fatwa of all the madhahib, four madhahib. And he, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, and Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim, the truth with him, or the best opinion, let me to say it, yani, the best opinion with him, with both, not with the imam. And all the law, Islamic law in our Islamic country, follow not Madhab Shafi'i, Maliki, Hanafi, Abu Hanifa, Hanbali, follow Ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn Khayyim. If you say three times at the time, Salafan, it's only one time, not three times. Not three times. We accept. Because we are looking for objectives of Sharia, looking for the best fatwa for our community. يعني ممكن نبدأ الآن أسئلة. Maybe you can.
So we couldn't recognize by with we knew of Dr. Salah. He has been 1 hour, but we couldn't recognize it's 1 hour, maybe 5 minutes, 6 minutes, something else. So we open the discussion now. If anybody has questions, please.
Assalamu alaikum. في أمريكا مثلا إن واحد يرث أبوه غير المسلم، تمام؟ فممكن الإفتاء في دون إن هو يرث. فأنا بس كنت عايز أعرف إيه الأسباب اللي حطتها اللجنة، الأسباب بالتفاصيل يعني، إيه الأسباب اللي أخذتها اللجنة علشان تفتي بهذا، يعني أسباب شرعية. سؤال، my question in English is the committee have many fatwas. Actually, I didn't get what is the fatwa for most of the examples, but one of the examples is that fatwa of inheritance from non-Muslim to Muslim. So I want to ask just what is the detailed reason for the fatwa that the committee takes that Muslim can inherit from non-Muslim, his father, I mean. So just I need this question. Thank you.
Okay. By attention, I did that. And come on, the seller will go so and so. What do you think?
One by one. How many persons have questions, please? One by one in this case.
Right.
One by one, inshallah.
I will go, inshallah, very fast. We looked for the old madahib about this issue. The Muslim can inherit non-Muslim or not. We found the majority of scholars said no. Because the hadith very clearly is a Muslim kafir, or is a kafir Muslim. The authentic hadith, Muslim cannot inherit non-Muslim, and non-Muslim cannot inherit the Muslim. Yeah. And we found many, many scholars have another opinion. According to something else. Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal, Sayyidina Zayd ibn Harith, Sayyidina Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, Sayyidina Muhammad ibn Hanafiyyah, Sa'id ibn Musayyib, Shaykh al-Tabi'in, Al-Imam Masruq, who is known as one of the great Mufassirin, Abdullah ibn Ma'qal, Ibn al-Sha'bi, Hassan al-Basri. And we look for the why they said this against the majority of scholars. They went to the hadith, al-Islam yuzid wa la yunqas. Al-Islam yuzid wa la yunqas. And if you convert to Islam, your rights is be, yeah, it has to be more, not less. They both two hadiths beside each other, and they, and Imam Abu Hanifa told between the Imam al-Arba'ah, the only case of this hadith, لا يرث المسلم الكافر إذا كان الكافر محاربا. If the non-Muslim, your father, your relative, go against Islam and make renounce war against Islam, you cannot inherit him and he cannot inherit you. Because they bring the hadith, give you a message, if you become Muslim, your rights, it will be more, not less. To encourage people to come to Islam. And you cannot agree about something, make people, if I convert to Islam, I will, and then suddenly, I have to go out of my house, I have to go out of, and I will leave the lecture life. We find this in our madhahib. And what is the problem to take one of this madhahib, to consider it as the case I mentioned to you, this case, the man died, has two sons, and one of them, yani, take drugs and everything, and another one, he became Muslim. Can ask him to leave all the money for this man to make more mischief and more sins, and the Muslim stand up without saying,
no. There's one thing I want to know is that what is the main reason of the hadith, the hurmaniya, why they say that it's haram? The main reason of inherited, why they say that it's haram to inherit from non-Muslim to Muslim? Is it because only he's a warrior who fight against you? Why his money is haram? Why this father, if he's a warrior, why his money is haram?
The majority of the scholars, they said it is the matter of loyalty, الولاء. And another Muslim said, no, it is not a matter of loyalty, it's a matter of, it is the money of people who يعني, make against you war, and we have to stop the relation between both to make clear this, don't make some people go with your يعني, enemy and يعني, the son, will he try to take care of his father, our father take ممكن تعمل عملاء يعني من الموضوع.
My opinion, I think in this point I don't have, I'm not a scholar, I can't say that, but what I see is that if the reason is that he's fighting you, taking his money, I think would be a reasonable to take his money to give it to Islam. I think you will stop one of the enemies of Islam, my thinking. One other thing is that we consider Mus'ab ibn Umayyah. When he converted to Islam, he didn't care about his money. He became much poorer than any other body. He couldn't find.
Our Prophet sent Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Jahsh to take the money from the trade of Amr ibn al-Hadrami because this is their money before. And the Battle of Badr, main reason to take the money from those people.
I mean, how to explain this? How to find the
money?
To take it,
المفروض ان انا افهم ان انا بس عشان بسال عشان اخلص ماشي انت الوقت لو انت سالت سؤال واحد وفهمت احسن من ان سالت 100 سؤال وما فهمتش
اعتقد انا فهمت يعني
انا ما فهمتش لو ممكن تشرح لي
بليز يعني هو طبعا يصعب انك تشرح كل الاسباب
عشان كده قلت لحضرتك انا عايز تفاصيل البتاع
التفاصيل بقى عايزين ساعتين للموضوع لان احنا خدنا 30 في
مثلا بي دي اف او فايل او اي حاجه
عندي فايل اي هاف فايل كان جيب او جيب انت ان شاء الله
اوكي برضه
نعم
السلام عليكم I stress about the importance of discussion of the scholars. For example, someone asking you, so you make research and discussion. But the point is, what should the questioner do while you are thinking? For instance, some lady is questioning, if he become Muslim, FC become Muslim, should he stay with his non-Muslim husband? But then, if the mujtahid made 1 year's time, what should he done at that? What she should done at that moment? Because he need to stay with or without her husband. He should choose at that time. So what should he
do? Our fatwa in the end is, if your husband prevent you to do your pillars of Islam, to read about Islam, to go out to the mosque and something like this, you have to get the divorce from him because he affects your religion. But if he leave you to do whatever you want according to the Sharia, and you have no way to live without him, you have no money, you have no covering for your life, you can stay with him. And we have very hard time to have this fatwa. We are different opinion in the fiqh council, but the fatwa is not all the scholar one way had this fatwa about non-Muslim. Muslim can help the Muslim. This fatwa, very hard time. And the best research about that among us, Dr. Abdullah Jubayr, is originally from Iraq, and he lives in London. And he made very deep search about the woman can stay or not. Let me to...
May I clarify?
To mention some of...
Can you ask about time?
Not discussing about your decision.
No.
Because, of course, the
after 1 year...
I mean, you delay the decision. You delay the answer, isn't it?
There's a time,
doctor.
Yes. Sometimes we answer to understand the atmosphere, the circumstances, everything, and make a specific fatwa. But for general fatwa, after searching, decision, the dialogue, and the most or all of us, or something like this. But you have to solve the problem. On the plate. Akhawatna fin. You have a right to ask. Father.
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم
السلام. حضرتك دلوقتي سؤالي بالنسبة للإفتاء Now we have a big flow of scholars coming from the media and say fatwa every day. And we are a general people. Some people sometimes confused. Although the scholars may be right, maybe all of them are right in their point of view. But this
flow only or flat.
What?
You have the flow of fatwa or flat.
Yes, flood of fatwa. Now it's flood of
fatwa.
So some scholars now, some general people who cannot understand or don't have mazhab or way or not how they can follow? They follow the least destructive for them or how they follow? So my question now, why not the fatwa come from one place for announcing for all? This is very important. And the use of media now, they are stressing on the minor fatwa and they make it a problem. And you listen many times as small fatwa, like, I don't say because some of them related to the desires of human being or something. So some fatwa, they stress on in media and the enemies of Islam take it and say to Muslims that they are talking about minor things and leave their work and big things. So as you said, big issue is very important. And this flood of fatwa makes the people confused, especially all of us not read too much.
أنا أدرك الحياة كويس لكن يعني the problem is the part of our ummah because our ummah like the orphan, no father and no mother. Now alhamdulillah we start the steps in Egypt and Libya, but everybody think about everything and no organization to make the fatwa for all of ummah, this minority, this majority, and this fatwa only for this case or this minorities. There's nothing like this. We are suffering in the fatwa council in Europe and India, America. We have no waqf, trust. We are looking for, we go. Wallahi, many times we pay our ticket. There is no anything for any scholar, for his search. Maybe he stay 2 years, make research. He only looking for the blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What you need to have big organization, some of search, some people to help us, look for this and this and this, and I can do 5 search, not one every yani year. If I have some assistant to help, لكن لا يوجد. We do our best. On the other hand, many of channels of TV, they need to make announcement about them to attract people. See the channel, and they bring sheikh and scholars, ask for anything, and sheikh make fatwa about. You know, wallahi, when many scholars stay here, make a meeting in the Gulf, and they invite me. It is acceptable in Sharia to have visa card or not? Yeah. All of them said it is haram, forbidden, it is riba, it is other, it is good. I stood, please, I have this visa card. If I not have this visa card, I will have problem in this and this. The Muslim in the West cannot live without this. You can't use money in some many places. You can't. And for me and for my fatwa, if I buy anything by the Visa card, I have to have the money in my bank. If the bill comes the same day, I didn't leave it until 1 month and have interest. The same day, I pay the bill. Never, ever, in the FIFA Fatura Authority, never, to make it late and have interest. What's the problem for that? Said no, because the contract has condition. The condition says, if you pay the bill late than 1 month or 2 months or 3 months, this is the condition, you will have interest, it's okay. This is a condition, I will not use it. But if this is the contract, make the contract haram. Ya jama'a, Imam Abu Hanifa said, الشرط الفاسد يصح العقد ويبطل الشرط. And Imam Abu Hanifa said, the shart, if you have spoiled condition, your contract is okay, and only this condition not okay. Like someone get married for daughter, and she said, I accept to be my husband with one condition. I have to live beside my mother in all my life. And he has to study here in Japan. Please come with me. No. This is our condition in the contract. Imam Abu Hanifa said, the contract is good. And this condition is not acceptable because it is against Sharia. أن نؤمن عند شروطه إلا شرط الحرام حلالا أو حل حراما. الله يقول سيروا في الأرض فيقول لا ما تسيرش في الأرض سير جنبهم لا تزري you have to be around my mother all your life. العهد صحيح والشرط باطل. تقول هذا الكلام جدا في منطقة خذ القرار سبت المجلس ومشيت قلت لا أبقى في مجلس يعني لا يعتبر أبجديات الفقه الإسلامي وقلت له خلاص انتوا احرار يعني. فاحنا عندنا most of the scholar never visit any country يعني he stay in his country only never visit another country and he made a fatwa about all the visa card and this and this and this. في سهل في الفرق في سهل في الفرق عايز التلفون مش عارف as I mentioned here for the general problem you have to take the decision from the council family council not person even if big scholar go to the decision of the family council not one person even if big scholar for the general problem small problem you can take any fatwa from the TV from anywhere now
okay.
جزاكم الله خير عشان المسؤول جاي الميكروفونين مره واحده شفت يا جماعه بقول لك العمده لما يحب يستحمى بيسخنوا له الترع
This is for our
government.
Yes. Go ahead. For the interesting lecture. I would like to speak about the one of the most problems here in Japan facing the Muslim community. Actually, the problem here in Japan, there is no fatwa center or fatwa council here in Japan. So we are facing problem about halal food, actually. So here in Japan, there is like mini juice containing alcohol with maybe little amount. And most of companies, they did not write what is the percent of alcohol inside. This is one matter. For the food, inside the food also there is many like substance like gelatin, giving also little amount, or some mucoside or amino acid. So also, for example, in some restaurant, they have like fish. Fish, of course, halal. But the problem is that they using, yes, the painting by some oil from the animal source, or using for frying this fish, the same oil that they make frying also for chicken. يعني يستخدموا نفس الزيت اللي بيقولوا فيه الفراخ هو نفس الزيت اللي بيقولوا فيه السمك. So there is some many matters came about the halal food, and we always like hearing many different opinions about this, and we have no authentic source here in Japan for giving fatwa. So if you can like conclude the main point related to halal food, it will be great. Jazakallah khair.
Jazakallah khair. I received this question 3 years ago, and the last 2 years also I came here, and I asked our brothers here to write details about everything of this, and I will introduce it to the Fiqh Council in Europe. Our Sheikh Al-Qaradawi and many big scholar will discuss it at a different situation from Europe. Europe, most of them Christian, and the community 55 million Muslim in the Europe, and they make halal food everywhere, and in the America the same thing. I think here we need specific fatwa, not general fatwa made it and the Fiqh Council in Europe or in the USA. But nobody, only us here. When I come here, I always have the same methodology of thinking. We have to know every detail and write by your hand because you are know the details more than us. Now you mentioned some details. The first time I hear about that, they use the same oil here and there. And this is some, yeah, maybe make a difference of the fatwa. So please try to make it with the right way once. It will solve the whole problem I'm asking many imams, please, you live with the community in Japan, and you can give us the more details and write it from the verticals, from the your Islamic center, MSA, Japan, anywhere. When we receive the Fiqh Council, a question from person, it is not like when we receive from the organizations. We start with the organization first and give the fatwa. If we have time, if we don't have time, we give 3 or 4 imams or scholars to make a fatwa about the individual fatwas. But for the general fatwa from the organizations, we come all of us, 40 scholars, and we discussion, and we set it before our meeting, body meeting, to have search and ask, maybe we need more question, with more answer about some question, we deliver some question, please answer this and this and this and this. Try to find out how much for the guillotine, how much for the... it is really make istihala, you cannot make this this material again to be alcohol or something like this. Al-Khal, Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, Qadir Takhlil, Al-Kham. All of these aspects we need really to... I can answer about many things of this, but I'm afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to... And also I don't like to go against my belief. I just said for the general issue, it has to come from the verticals and not the person. I read, when you talk with me, the phone, I read some, but I feel it is not enough. And if it is enough, I feel also it is better to go to the verticals and give them my answer, and the scholar said, your answer is not good, your answer is good, your answer maybe we need to add some conditions, and then the fatwa will be better than to deliver this fatwa now. For general, taqillaha masata'at. Taqillaha masata'atum asma'u ati'u. Foreign Muslim who cannot eat their food, laysu min ahli al-kitab, not Christian or Jewish. Try as much as you can to find out halal food from أنا دائما أفكر في طريق المجموعات أو الناس تفكر في حل المشكلة individual بطرش حلال. لكن لما تقول تجمع الناس المعنيين بالحلال فود وتقول إحنا في أمريكا الآن 200,000 واحد 100,000 واحد 50,000 واحد. If you speak with any company, we need halal food, no alcohol, no oil from the board, no kada. Many places, wallahi, you will start something for the future. But if we only ask to solve the problem individual, we will stay under pressure, under others. In the fatwa of mortgage, I told the Shuyukh at this time, now we find a solution for individual Muslims, but we don't encourage the community to make Islamic economic in our area. And later on, some Muslim made an Islamic company, and we help them. لما قوم يقولوا لتعامل إيجار المنتهي بالتمليك، بس لما قلنا إيجار المنتهي بالتمليك، القيمة اللي قلنا تخصم من الضرائب. طب لو كتبوها فايده القيمه الايجاريه هتخصم من الضرائب. احنا اخذنا كتب فايده لانها في ظل علم المقاصد نوب روبن هو عقد صحيح ايجار منتهي بالتمليك. يعني انت بتدفع مثلا بين 100,000 معك 20% تملك 80% تملك 20% وتاجر 80% ده بيسميه ايجار. اللي بتدفعه ايجار ولا انترست؟ اذا كتبت ايجار لا يخصم من الضرائب، انترست يخصم من الضرائب، قدر يكتب انترست. احنا مش جامدين. لكن بنقدر نتصرف اذا كان في اطار المقاصد العامه للشريعه الاسلاميه. ف we try to think all the time about the the حكم الشرعي, the decision of الشريعه, with the objectives of الشريعه. And for any general problems, we need to write every details and present it to the scholars, 30 council, and I guarantee to bring the good fatwa for this issue in the later part of the future.
Inshallah, we have 10 minutes. We have two questions, brother Hisham and brother Bashar. Sister, have questions?
Sir,
I have a question, a very simple question, okay, but maybe it is different for me. If you have, if I have as a normal Muslim, two fatwa, one is more restricted than other, and these two fatwa from respected source for me, one is more restricted than other. So, in this case, which is better? Okay, just to follow this restricted fatwa, because it is more restricted, and in this case I become in the same side. Even this fatwa is I don't accept this fatwa in my mind. Okay, and I feel the second fatwa is more correct. Okay, so two fatwa from respected source.
One is restricted.
Because now we are very confused, okay, even in Egypt, okay, some groups, okay, one group say this group doesn't understand, and this group say that this group doesn't understand. So we are little confused about that. So for me, okay, which is better, follow the fatwa which I feel this is correct, okay, or I just follow the restricted fatwa because this is not safe.
Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is Sahih Hadith al-Bukhari and the Muslim, when he sent Mu'adh ibn Jabal and Abu Musa al-Ash'ari to Yemen, he said, Yassira wa la tu'assira, bashira wa la tunafira, wa ta'awana, yani fi kalima wa'ayt minni, wa la takhtarifa. Yani, فالبداية الحديث التيسير والتبشير. Our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam commands Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal and Abu Musa al-Ash'ari when they went to lead the Muslim community in Yemen to make the fatwa easy, not difficult, not restrict. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قل يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I want to make your life easier, not very hard life. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in many hadith, in Aisha radiallahu anha said, she said, ما خير النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بين أمرين إلا اختار أيسرهما ما لم يكن إثما. If our Prophet sallam has a choice between hard fatwa or easier fatwa, he always take easier fatwa, accept it is haram. To do something haram. التيسير, Imam النجيم في كتاب الأشباه والنظائر, والإمام السيوطي في كتاب أيضا الأشباه والنظائر, they announced about big principle in Islam, المشقة تنفي بالتيسير. If you have hard situation, it is by itself, it is called for the something easier. Our Prophet Muhammad went with the soldiers, with the companion, to make a battle of Fath Makkah. The first day, most of them of the army pray fast in Ramadan. It was Ramadan. And the second day, some fasted and some break their fast. وَأَنْتَصُمُ خَيْرُ لَكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. The third day, the people who continue to fast, they have no effort to serve others, to take care of themselves. And our Prophet said, ذَهَبَ الْمُفْتُرُونَ الْيَوْمَ بِالْأَجْرِ. The people who break their siyam, they have more reward than the people keep their siyam, their fasting. And after a few days, those people who continue to fast, they get lost. قالوا إجمال يعني
مسجد الكونشس
فنتين. Then our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to the high thing and stayed and stood for very high thing and bring the water on the front of everybody. And he drink water in the day of Ramadan. And he said, ليس من البر الصيام في السفر. الرواية الصحيحة بتقول الرسول قالها بلغة القوم الذين مر بينهم. ليس من البر أم صيام في السفر. لأن لغة القوم دول كانت الألف واللام بتتقلب ألف ميم. فليس من البر. There is no part of righteous to keep your siyam even you have this hard time and you feel down. Everybody has to break his fasting today and we command everyone to break his fasting. ثم قال إنكم مصبحوا عدوكم غدا والفطر أعوذ لكم. Tomorrow you will face your enemies and if you break your fasting you will be very strong to fight. Don't keep your siyam. You see, the first day it's okay. The second day it's okay. Third day, the people who break their fasting is better than keep their fasting. And the end, no. You cannot continue to have fasting. You have to break your fasting. That مشي مع الحال. If your mind and your heart say that another fatwa is easier, it is better, it is useful, more useful, go to their fatwa. This fatwa, if your heart, your mind, and the sheikh has two things, as I mentioned, خَشِّ قَلْبِيَ حُبَّ شَوَيَّ. They fear Allah, and they have good knowledge. Now. Hold on.
Brother Bashar, this is brother, and we finish inshallah. Some sisters have some questions? Three sisters have questions?
Brother Bashar
and the brother and finish inshallah. 15 minutes just.
Jazakumullah. So I'm actually wondering, like the companion at the time of the Prophet, they did not need fatwa, they were the perfect people, and if they needed fatwa, they could have gotten the perfect fatwa. So the companion actually did not need a fatwa and they were the most perfect people and they have the best example. And the tabi'een also did not need a fatwa and they spread Islam. And we actually were asking about small details. We are looking for many fatwas. And we are actually as Muslim worthless as the Prophet described us, like the foam in the water. So why? I'm just wondering why.
Why about what? I didn't get your.
Why we are asking about small details, looking for many fatwas, and as Sahaba and Tabi'in, the companion and the people after them, did not need these fatwas, and they were a better example compared to us. In Arabic.
You know, in. The Isaac Sahaba is okay. You know, the companion, they were very busy about to open the new land, to spread message to Islam for everyone. Yes. They were concerned about to clean their hearts, to strengthen their iman, to make sacrifice, not to have everything. The big difference between us and the Sahaba is the Sahaba, they have abilities. They are ready to spend everything for the sake of Allah, to spread Islam, and we need to have everything to us and start after that to serve Islam. They, like, see Abu Bakr Siddiq spent all his money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of them, they went to the battle and they are under pressure, they may be cut. And they receive it with habits. But we need to have more money, have good life, have good position. Christian, good authorities, and after that, we can serve Islam. This is the big difference. If you don't come to Islam and you are ready to make sacrifice for everything in your life, even your soul, you will not be able to serve Islam.
Now,
سؤال about the khutbah, it is duty to be in Arabic. Some ulama said it is duty to be in Arabic. ومنهم مذهب الإمام أبو حنيفة الرحمن. أو على الأقل the most of it, the يعني introduction and أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله and the ayah, تقوى الله, it has to be in Arabic. And after that, if you be in any language, it's okay. I think to gather all of this, I encourage the imams in any community to make the introduction in Arabic and the subject in English and the end dua in Arabic. To gather all of this and make the khutbah acceptable for any madhab. And this is a way to please everybody, I don't ignore your madhab and take only one madhab. All of it in Arabic, or all of it in English, or all of it in Urdu, in Japanese. Try to make it يعني, like collection, inshallah. خلاص؟
Now, inshallah, thank you so much for the Salah. We'll finish the session, we'll have break 10 minutes. After this, we'll continue, inshallah.